She's waiting like an iceberg, waiting to change. But she's cold inside, she wants to be like the water.
For visitors to come to Castara and enjoy Castara, the best way to do it is to link immediately with the locals. They will help you, they'll explain everything to you, they'll make life so easy for you. But you must communicate with the locals and they will help you the best way.
Drop your shoulders, forget the machinery, touch type, computer type life that you're accustomed to, and lend yourself into the local type life way of the people. And be as native as a person, even for 7 days or 10 days as possible. But that makes it so enjoyable for you.
Well, if I take you on a native tour, you'll see things that you won't believe, like we have 210 species of birds, we have a few animals, we have 14,000 acres of protected rainforest, and it's interesting, and you learn a lot about trees and plants, and there are medical plants where you can use for like kidney problem, gallstones. There's so much to discover here. If you're staying at close hangar, you'll see a lot of birds or fishermans. You'll see blue grey tanager, you'll see blue crowned mock-mart, house wren. Even our national bird, Rufus ventis shakalaka, you'll see the golden olive woodpecker, and a lot more. Castara, you'll see a lot. For instance, like the oven that's made out of clay, wonderful bread, sweet bread, tart, bone. It's from way back after slavery. When slavery abandoned in 1838, a lot of the people went on their own, so they had a clay oven where they made their local breads and their gardens. And we still have some here. A lot of fruit trees, banana, plantain, coconut, because we used to export a lot. And it's still nice in Tobago, it's still like the olden days. It's just that we have a lot of buildings going up, but you still see a lot of native in Castara. Okay. Lovely people. Yeah. Any information you want, they can direct you. Yeah. Any problem you have, you can speak to anybody from Castara. Yeah. It's Castara is a dream come true for a visitor. About the local fishermen, it's a pleasure to see them pulling nets in, because they start way back, you know. In those days, there was not much money, so the farmers used to exchange with the fishermen fish for food. So some used to go pull the net, some used to plant garden, and when they all have the harvest, they exchange. It's not so anymore. Now you have to buy everything. Hey!
Wahoo, wahoo.
I caught the board, it was just saying, I just take the hook out.
Hey, how many did you get more?
Four more.
Yeah.
Oh, that's good idea.
Yeah.
Yeah.